Elementary School. Tigers, you're doing a great job with remote learning. We are so proud of you and the work you're doing. This week, we've got some other stuff coming up. Supply pickup. Mr. Abbey, tell us all about it.
All right. This Thursday, October 15th, is our next supply pickup. And remember, Tigers, at the supply pickup from 8 a.m. to 6 p.m., we are also collecting food at these pickups to support the Maple Valley Food Bank. At our last supply pickup, our Tiger families donated over 15 boxes of food. Here's a picture of Mr. Bubbles at the food bank when our recess teachers delivered the food to the food bank. All the food donated filled up an entire huge bin. Way to go, Tigers. Remember, we are collecting non-perishable food items again this Thursday from 8 a.m. to 6 p.m.
This Thursday. Way to go. Way to be community contributor, Tigers. Okay, awesome work. Lunch Bunch.
All right, we've just finished our second round of Lunch Bunches. We're starting our third round today. These lunches, Lunch Bunches have been so much fun. We've done stories, scavenger hunts, charades, and some dad jokes. Hey, Mr. Mitchell. I made a pencil with two erasers. It was pointless.
Oh, I love it.
Here's the Lunch Bunches for this week. Today is first grade. Tuesday is third grade. And Wednesday, we'll have our fifth grade Lunch Bunches. Lunch Bunches are from 12 to 12:30. We'll see you there.
All right. Blue Fridays. Seahawks. Man, they are looking good. 4-0.
Yeah. We've been seeing
maybe 5-0 today.
Yes. We've been seeing some great spirit from our Tigers. Check out some of these pictures.
Great pictures, Tigers, and wow, go Hawks.
Yes.
The Seahawks don't play this week, but you can still dress in your team gear for your favorite sports teams this week, like the Dallas Cowboys.
All right. Who's that Tiger? All right, check out this picture of our amazing Tigers and our special Tiger filter. Who do you think that is? Can you guess?
I got it.
It's Mrs. McGowan!
All right. Great teacher, really cool. Hey, student spotlight. The last few weeks we have been featuring our Tigers who have been showing the future ready trait of being a self-directed learner. Teachers have continued to notice those Tigers who are showing this trait during lessons and class meetings. Here's some of those names right here. They've been doing great. Great job. The cabinets are bare and I'm unaware of just how we got into this mess. Got so aggressive. I know we meant all good intentions. So pull me closer. Why don't you pull me close? Why don't you come on over? I can't just let you go. Oh, baby. Great job, Tigers. For all those Tigers who've been recognized over the past few weeks, we are going to be getting you certificates in your supply kits this Thursday. What?
Next week, we're gonna be recognizing one last group of Tigers as self-directed learners, and then we're gonna be moving on to a different Future Ready skill for the month of November, and we'll preview that one in a couple of weeks. Nice job, Tigers.
Right, hey. We've been featuring people every week that work at this school, so this week on Who in the Lake, we want to share and introduce some different staff. So, this week we have
Mrs. White!
Yes.
She is our amazing STEAM teacher. We know that you guys have been doing art right now. Great job.
Hey, story time. That story was so great last week. What's going on with story time this week, Mr.
All right, Tigers. After the Pledge of Allegiance on Tiger TV, we're gonna have another story time with Mrs. Smith, our Shadow Lake librarian. Remember, she is reading stories with you that are part of the Children's Choice Picture Book Award nominees. Today, she is gonna be reading a book called Be Kind. Yeah, we hope you guys enjoy it.
All right, Tigers, turn your attention to your teacher for the Pledge of Allegiance, and remember,
it's a great day to be a Tiger.
Tigers. Hey, how's everybody doing out there? All right, we are going to read our second award-winning picture book today, and today it is called Be Kind. This is something we all can work on all the time, right? So this is called Be Kind, written by Pat Zietlow Miller. Tanisha spilled grape juice yesterday. All over her new dress. Everyone laughed. I almost did too. But Mom always told me to be kind. So I tried. I don't think it worked. I said, "Purple is my favorite color." I thought Tanisha would smile, but she ran into the hall instead. When she came back, snack time was over. She put on her art smock and didn't look at anyone. I almost told Tanisha that art was my favorite class, but I didn't want her to leave again. So I painted purple splotches and added some green until I had a bunch of beautiful violets. While I painted, I thought about Tanisha. Should I have handed her my napkin? Let her borrow my sweatshirt? Spilled my juice so everyone stared at me instead? What does it mean to be kind anyway? Maybe it's giving. Making cookies for Mr. Rinaldi, who lives alone. Letting someone with smaller feet have my too tight shoes. He might win races in them too. Maybe it's helping. Putting dirty dishes in the sink. Cleaning up after Otis, our class guinea pig. He's a messy eater. Maybe it's paying attention. Telling Desmond I like his blue boots. Asking the new girl to be my partner. Listening to Aunt Franny's stories, even the ones I've heard before. Being kind should be easy, like throwing away a wrapper or recycling a bottle or saying thank you, bless you. My mom says the quickest way to be kind is to use people's names. Hey, Kayla. What's new, Omar? Good afternoon, Rabbi Mandelbaum. Being kind can be hard, too. Even when you know what to do, teaching someone something I'm good at is tricky. Even when I'm patient. And sticking up for someone others when other kids aren't kind is really hard and really scary. Maybe I can't solve Tanisha's grape juice problem. Maybe all I can do is sit by her in art class and paint this picture for her because I know she likes purple too. Maybe I can only do small things. But my small things might join small things other people do. And together, they could grow into something big. Something really big. So that all our kindnesses spill out of our school and spread throughout the town. Travel across the country and go all the way around the world. Right back to Tanisha and me so we can be kind again and again. And again. There's Tanisha hanging up her new picture. And that is Be Kind. So remember, always choose kindness. All right, Tigers, have a great day, and we'll see you next week.